This was in 2012 when we had the Conservative government under Prime Minister Harper. And over the years, the government had enacted a number of different policies that really seemed to attack science. So funding cuts for science, muzzling government scientists, policy decisions that seemed to completely ignore all the available evidence. And then they introduced this omnibus budget bill that cut a lot of funding and particularly closed the Experimental Lakes area. And this sort of felt like it was the last straw. And so we decided we wanted to organize something to show that the science community was really unhappy and really concerned about these policies. And so this led to the Death of Evidence rally. It was, you know, really one of the largest science protests that we had seen in Canada, if not the largest. So I think there was really just that sense of it being, you know, really unusual to see thousands of scientists out in the streets protesting. There was already this concern that was out there, and then I think the Death of Evidence rally sort of gave the scientists an outlet to express that frustration. After the rally, which we really planned to just be one event, people kept coming up to us and saying, you know, that was incredible, that was the first time I've ever participated in a rally, like, what's next? And at the time, nothing was next. And so it really seemed like there was the need and the demand for an organization that was really advocating for science, evidence-based decision-making, and its role in our democracy. And so we founded Evidence for Democracy. We are a nonprofit organization that promotes the transparent use of evidence in decision-making in Canada. And we do that by educating and mobilizing the science community. E4D basically works to make sure that research in Canada is well-funded, openly communicated to the public, and actually used in government decision-making in Canada. And we do this through issue advocacy campaigns. The foundation of Evidence for Democracy is that we all benefit when governments are making decisions that are based on science and evidence. And so, obviously, one way for the government to not use science is to just ignore it. But another way for governments to not use science is to cut funding for it so that we just don't have that information. When the government doesn't let scientists communicate their work to the public, you know, for me, this really raises red flags about our democratic process. Is this information saying things that are inconvenient for them? And ultimately, you know, this is information that can potentially be used by the public to hold the government accountable. And so it's really important that that information is getting out openly and easily to the public.